So continuing with the abutments, abutment is a structure upon which the ends of a bridge rest and is referred to as, this is referred to as an abutment. So the most common type of abutment structure is a retaining wall, although other types of abutments are also possible and are used. So a retaining wall is used to hold back an earth embankment or water and to maintain a sudden change in elevation. So abutment will serve the following function. It distributes the load from the bridge ends to the ground, withstands any load that are directly imposed on it, provides vehicular and pedestrian access to the bridge. So in case if it's a retaining wall type abutment, the bearing capacity and the sliding resistance of the foundation materials and the overturning stability must be checked. So abutments are used at the ends of the bridges. One is to retain the embankment, and it also carries the vertical and the horizontal forces from the superstructure. They could be designed as piers or retaining walls, and they should be able to withstand against overturning and sliding. The footing should be designed to avoid differential settlement and excessive horizontal movements. Since any structure is constructed on the soil, there should not be, especially the abutment should not overturn or slide because of the effects of the differential settlement or any horizontal movements is there because of the earthquakes or any other forces. There are different types of abutments. We have stub abutments, partial depth abutments, full depth and integral abutments. So partial depth abutments are located approximately at mid depth of the front slope of the approach embankment. The higher back walls and wing walls may retain the fill material, or the embankment slope may continue behind the back wall. In the later case, a structural approach slab or end span will be present, and curtain walls will be provided to close off the open area. Full depth abutment. The full depth abutments are located to the approximate front toe of the approach embankment, restricting the opening of the structure. In this sketch, you can see an integral abutment, that is the abutment which is integrated with the structure. So this is a U abutment, gravity abutment with wing walls. These are the other types of classification. Spill through abutments, pile bend abutment. This is the picture of a pile bend abutment and a spill through abutment. How the abutment should be selected, what is the procedure that should be selected is most appropriate. So it should be based, it is normally based on the following consideration, that is the construction and maintenance cost, cut or fill earthwork situation, traffic maintenance during construction, construction period, safety of construction workers, availability and cost of backfill material, superstructure depth, size of the abutment, horizontal and vertical alignment changes, area of excavation, aesthetics and similarity to adjacent structures, previous experience with the type of the abutment, ease of access for inspection and maintenance, anticipated life, loading condition and accessibility of deformation. So these are the some of the criteria that should be considered for the selection of the abutment.